video, I'll be covering the radius of curvature for a projectile. Let us take a projectile motion where particle is given initial velocity of u at an angle theta with the x-axis. This we have taken as x, this is y. And let us take a point here which is x and at y coordinates. So at this location, when the particle is there at a certain point of time, let the time be t, we want to know what is the curvature, radius of curvature. Now before we do that, we should know that if a particle is moving with a velocity v and we draw a normal from the velocity component, the acceleration is, the normal acceleration is in this direction, and the radius curvature is then v square upon an. This is the basic by which we will derive the whole formula for the radius of curvature for the projectile. Now at this location, let us assume that the velocity is v and the angle at which it is from the horizontal, that is x, is alpha. Do not confuse between theta and alpha. Alpha is the angle at that particular moment which the velocity v is making with the horizontal. The components of velocity are vx, vy, and this is the resultant velocity v at that point. At that point, this is the resultant velocity. We know that vx remains constant all through. Vx is u cos theta, but vy is varying because of the gravity, the acceleration g. We can write it as gj minus gj, that is in the negative direction. So vy would be, we are taking the, in this direction we are taking things as positive and this direction it is negative. That is why when we write equation for velocity, vy is equal to initial velocity, which was u sine theta in y direction, minus, we have to write minus because gravity is in this direction, so acceleration is negative, so minus g t. T is the time as I mentioned initially, and vx is also equal to x upon t at this point, if t is the time. So we can write t as x upon u cos theta. We will place the value of t here, we get vy is equal to u sine theta minus gx u cos theta is the value of the vy. Now this is the angle alpha. When we know vx and vy, we can find out the velocity v. V would be equal to vector vx plus vector vy. Never make the mistake of straight away adding vx and vy. These are in vector form and direction has to be taken into consideration. Since both are perpendicular to each other, that is why we write v is equal to vx square plus vy square under root. We can place the value of vx and vy and obtain the value of v. Now coming to, all this is okay, all this is fine. You may ask what is the radius of curvature. Now coming back to this diagram, if I draw it again, and this is the velocity, this is the angle with the horizontal, this is vx and this is vy. Now acceleration we know is in this direction. G is acting in this direction. We need the component of this acceleration which is normal to the velocity, which will be this. Its value would be, now this is alpha, so this will also be alpha. It is perpendicular to velocity. This will also be alpha, so this is g cos alpha. So our relationship now gets reduced to rho is equal to v square upon g cos, it is alpha, g cos alpha. Now we know that Vx is equal to u cos theta. Vx is equal to u cos theta, and Vx is also equal to v cos alpha. From here, Vx is equal to v cos alpha. So v cos alpha is equal to u cos theta. So cos alpha is u cos theta upon v. This is another relationship. We place the value of cos alpha here. We get rho is equal to v square upon g u cos theta into one more v. So radius is v cube upon g u cos theta. This is an important relationship, and by this method you can find the radius of curvature at any point. Only thing you need to do is to find, you will be given the initial velocity, you will be given cos theta will be known, because theta will be given, g is known, and we can be easily found by this relationship. V is equal to u square cos square theta plus u square sine square theta plus g square x square u square cos square theta minus twice u gets cancelled, minus twice g x tan theta, minus twice g x tan theta, sine upon cos theta is 10, and u gets cancelled, it is minus twice g x tan theta. This is the value of v raised to the power 1 upon 2. This comes to this, if we simplify it, it comes to v is equal to bracket u square plus g square x square upon u square cos square theta minus twice g x tan theta 1 upon 2. If you place the value of v in this relationship which we had found, v rho was equal to v cube upon g u cos theta, and value of v is available with us. We know what is the value of u theta and x. We know the location at which we want to find out the radius of curvature. Interestingly, this formula also resembles the other relationship which is generally given in the books. Generally in the books it is given that radius of curvature is equal to 1 plus dy upon dx whole square raised to power 3 upon 2 d square y upon dx square. And if you put the value of dy upon dx and d square y upon dx square and apply this formula, you will get the same relationship which we get by the earlier derivation which I have done. So you can use any of the method for finding the radius of curvature. If you use this formula, this second one which I have written here, here you will have to apply this relationship, y is equal to x tan theta minus g x square upon u square cos square theta twice. So you have to use this relationship. You can find dy by dx, which is tan theta minus gx upon u square cos square theta. You square it and add 1 to it, and then apply that formula, and d square y by dx square is equal to minus g upon u square cos square theta. So you can place the value of these two in that equation, then also you can get the radius of curvature. You will get the same result by both the formulas. If you try to put that value which we had obtained for v and compare it, the result which you get by putting these values, it will be same result. So that is all about the radius of curvature. Generally the question is asked for this point, and for this point it is very easy to find out. If it is to be written for the highest point, it is very simple, because here the velocity is v u x, which is u cos theta, and g is known. So if you put the relationship, rho was v square upon a n. V square is how much? V square is u square cos square theta, and a n is g. This is the relationship, and if you recollect the formula which we derived, rho was equal to v cube upon g u cos theta. And what was v cube? V cube would be u cube cos cube theta upon g u cos theta. So it comes u square cos square theta upon g. Same result you have obtained. So for this point there is no problem at all. Try to use this formula. Rho, the radius is equal to v square upon a n. V is known, that is u cos theta, because there is no vertical component at the highest point and the horizontal velocity remains constant all through. We know that the gravity is in this direction, velocity resultant is in this direction, so the acceleration is normal to the velocity. And for radius of curvature, we need the velocity square divided by the normal component, the acceleration which is normal to the velocity. So it is very easy for the highest point, but for the other point, try to use this formula or this formula to obtain the radius of curvature for the projectile. So that's all about the radius of curvature. Thank you.